It's now been confirmed that the source of the outbreak was definitely the cooling tower at Broadcasting House in the heart of the West End. It's estimated the bug spread rapidly after April the 19th, during humid weather conditions. Today, 1 month later, the medical experts held their first news conference. They announced that although their surveillance was continuing, they were winding down their operation because the incubation period for the disease is now over.
I think we can safely say that from the 2nd of May, there's been no danger of acquiring infection from this particular outbreak. I'm not saying that you won't find Legionella if you sample water towers. I think probably Dr. Bartlett could actually expand a bit on that.
Oh, yes, indeed. And we would expect surveys of cooling water systems in various parts of the country have shown that up to 50% of cooling water systems may be colonised by Legionella, but only a small proportion by the subtype which causes Legionnaires' disease.
Members of the Broadcasting Union Beta who attended the conference say they're not satisfied that enough has been done to warn the BBC staff and the public of the dangers. They say an internal BBC technical inquiry, which is underway, is not enough. With two of their members dead, they're calling for a full public inquiry.
My members are unhappy about many of the circumstances. I don't want to accuse the BBC. They made enormous efforts to track down, for instance, every person who was off sick to make sure whether they were possibly suffering from the disease. But that still, as far as I'm concerned, merits an independent investigation.
There are now 42 confirmed cases, 44 more suspected. Four are seriously ill and could still die. Meanwhile, the results of tests on 24 other air conditioning systems in the surrounding area are still being assessed. Mark Longhurst for Thames News.